Hey, good afternoon, everybody. Mark again here, Weatherman Plus. I got a big update on what's going on with this next storm, potential Gulf Hurricane East Coast storm that is coming around the corner. We also got severe weather for today and tomorrow, chances for damaging winds and tornadoes. So I also have this in the video. Remember, timestamps are below in the description. Just go down and click more and you'll get more. If you've never been here before, make sure you subscribe. I am all year long. Make sure you click the bell so you do get the afternoon updates. Thank you everyone for helping sharing the information, hitting the like on the video, and getting this information out to more people. I appreciate it so much. Now, this Gulf hurricane is still showing possible, and it is showing a lot of hurdles that this potentially has to jump and go around before that could happen. It has two paths that this storm could form into. Now, what I can see is that we have a chance for this system to form. When we get this trough coming down, it could produce a surface low around the Western Caribbean and go into this direction, potentially strengthening up as well. Now, if it does not make this first interaction, going under the trough, it will go further to the west, and then it'll get pulled up into the Gulf of Mexico as we get in our next strong system coming in, bringing a trough, pulling both of them at the same time. Now you can see over here, we do have a little outlook for maybe Gordon coming back, trying to do something, but still going away. It's not gonna be a big deal. Gordon just don't wanna go away. Now you can see this on the GFS, also on the Euro, that big trough coming in on the East Coast, your negative NAO. You can also see this on the GFS, that you have that trough coming in, that negative NAO on the East Coast. But we can also notice that after it goes by the 22nd, that trough is going to be moving away. You can also see this on the Euro. Once it passes by the 22nd, that trough is going to be going away. So the deepest part is around the 21st or 22nd, and this will bring storms towards the Western Caribbean from Jamaica towards the Cayman Islands, maybe even some buildup over there along the front by Central America as well. But then things are going to change. This is literally 6 or 7 days before we get past that part. Also shown on our latest potential velocity anomaly. And look at all the intensity that is coming into our direction late September through early October. Now this is also what's forming up in the United States, the lower 48, and what's forming up in the Caribbean, potentially the Gulf of Mexico still, and going east along the East Coast, potentially as a strong storm also. Now things in the atmosphere, you can see the water temperature, sea surface temperature, still very warm waters for this wave as it comes through, still very much above average temperatures. And you can also see the update on the chances for a tropical depression, where this system could potentially form. So you can see how you can have a system coming while we get in that trough right here, forming up by the Western Caribbean. And then after that trough moves east, it could potentially go north into the Gulf of Mexico still and get a piece in the Eastern Pacific. And you can see the updates showing further north of a push into the Gulf of Mexico. Now you can see these two opportunities when you look here for a chance for a tropical cyclone. So first, all the way until the 23rd, you have a chance for something to form up on that trough and get pushed to the east. If it doesn't make that one, you see how it strengthens up all the way to the 30th. This is where that trough builds up and forms up your best chance for something to form up. Now we've been seeing this going right over Cuba, going right by Florida, the Bahamas, going right over this way, maybe even a little bit closer of an angle and go right on the coast. So we've been seeing that as well. But after this, because if it does not make this, there's another chance that after that trough, it's going to go west, right into that Gulf of Mexico. Now, there's still a lot of things in the atmosphere that could stop this system from having issues. Potentially a cold front seen by GFS. It could bring some dry air as well, and it could bring more shear. And you can see a lot of these issues with the latest on the Euro. So as we start getting that system, PTC-8 rolling to the northeast, bringing y'all a little bit of rainfall as well. We get this high pressure rolling around. We get that deep trough still on the West Coast. But this is where we got that trough working right here. Big deep trough working right here. And this is where it tries to form up something right here into the Western Caribbean, going potentially over Central America and putting some landfall interaction on that. Could keep that weak if it keeps going further to the south. Now, after you pass the 22nd, now your trough is gone. It is moving further to the east. It's taking PTC 8 out into the Atlantic, and that's going to strengthen up to something over there. But then we have our system getting pulled northern while we get this strong system coming into the lower 48. So whether you're going to get impacted by this potential Gulf hurricane going around the East Coast or this storm system coming in, this next transition is going to affect everybody. Now, the only good news is the latest run with deterministic of a year, showing literally in 5 days, this system will be over here a little further to the south in the Caribbean, run over land interaction while we're getting that trough, and it can't go nowhere on this run. It's too far to the south. It's too weak. Then after the trough passes by, then it tries to pull back to the north, and it tries to get back together. Now, if you take a look at it, on this shot right here, it is literally all over landfall. This will keep it so weak, it would have really a hard time to form. And by the time that system comes pulling in with that trough, it could pull it out quickly where it really won't have a lot of chances to form. Now, when you look at the size of this, you're talking about a huge area of rotating atmosphere. This is very huge. Matter of fact, look at the difference in all the different surface low pressures, multiple vorticities in that whole area. And whichever one it takes, we still don't know yet. Whichever one it goes is what's going to be the outcome. One's going to be a stronger outcome. One's going to be a weaker outcome. Now, when you look with the GFS to see what the GFS is thinking, also another good model, American model, you can see the trough coming in, very deep trough, but now we're by the 21st, 22nd, and you can see how it's starting to get a little bit of spin, a little bit of rotation in the atmosphere on these waves, and it could potentially pull this out. Now, if it catches the first trough in the very beginning, it will be a threat towards Jamaica, maybe a little bit of the Cayman Islands, going over Cuba, potentially over the Bahamas, while it's getting pulled out by PTC 8 right into the Atlantic. Now, if it does not meet that one, it will be blocked by this high pressure that is expanding all over the Gulf of Mexico, and nothing can head north for a moment. Now, once that passes, we have that strengthening storm coming down while it pulls that wave to the north. And that's where all that is coming into play. Still showing it would be either a weak hurricane or a strong tropical storm still going right up the whole East Coast. Now, there's a few things that could hinder this storm. Showing when we get that trough, it will start putting some shear on it in the Western Caribbean. Now, after that trough, and that trough moves to the east, that storm system comes in, pulls this to the north, and it starts showing that maybe a cold front comes in and starts putting a lot of shear on the northern side of that system. This is the latest update. Potentially weakening it down to where it's just a weak Cat 1 hurricane is strong enough, but still it would be way better than a major. Showing it could potentially have shear on it the whole time. Now, if that cold front shows true, it also would bring some dry air inside this system. So you can see as you have this big pile of tropical moisture getting together, and after it starts going north, coming in with a potential cold front coming in with that system and bringing a lot of dry air. Now, on this scenario, if this does show the play out, Mississippi, potentially Alabama, Louisiana, and definitely Texas, you are all in the clear from this system. This will become a Georgia, Florida, and along the East Coast system at that point, maybe a little bit of eastern Alabama. And that is what is trending. We have seen some runs go a little further to the west in the Gulf of Mexico where it could still be a potential issue. But all these impacts will be east side loaded. So just keep that in mind. So latest update with GFS shows after you go 5 days, you see how this runs into Central America. This keeps all of that weak. We have a deep trough coming in, keeping all this convection very far over Central America. This will bring y'all some rainfall down there. And after you go towards 6 days and 7 days, then it starts pulling north. You see how it starts going on that northeast push? And then it goes to that western push. So that trough is trying to pull this out by September 24th. This would affect potentially Jamaica, the Cayman Islands, Cuba, and the Bahamas, and maybe some of southern Florida if that were to get pulled out. And on this run, it don't get pulled out. It goes further to the west. That storm system comes in, still showing a strong storm, coming to the Gulf and going right up the coast, still a strong tropical storm, still showing a hurricane in the Gulf. Now, when this comes in, this is going to go potentially all up the East Coast, all the way to the Northeast as a strong tropical storm. The artificial intelligence of the Euro shows the same thing. As you go 6 days, something weak, staying right below that radar of that trough, putting shear on it because of that trough as well. Once that trough leaves, gets pulled to the north, and you have that hurricane again in the Gulf, but this one weakens as it goes up the coast. Now, the Canadian sees all this low pressure crashed into Central America while we got that trough, and still takes it to where it heads to north. See how it starts going up that trough? You see how it starts going up that trough? Then it takes that western push towards the Gulf, towards that system, still showing a hurricane coming right towards the Big Bend of Florida on the 25th, 26th, and going right up the states. Still a hurricane right there, all over Tennessee, Georgia, and South Carolina. And you can see this as it goes on land. It stays strong all the way up to the Carolinas and continues to head north all the way towards Ohio. Showing by the Canadian that as that trough comes in, it could pull off a piece of it, but it will not affect the majority of this wave. And after that high pressure gets away from the Gulf, boom, heads north, goes right for that storm system with that trough and pulls it. You see how it grabs it and it pulls it straight north all up the coast. Latest on the ensemble shows in 6 days will be something weak according to the control member. You do see a few of them show it could start strengthening up already. And as you go further towards 7 days, as you go towards 8 days, showing it will start strengthening up right there on that region. And you can see where majority of them are showing it could be even making a landfall already. That is not trending, but you can see where majority is showing somewhere is over around Western Caribbean. Now, this one right here is taking that turn early on E8. Now, if you go further, you'll see it still shows that it will eventually take that turn. Turn a little bit sooner than the run that we had this morning, but still riding right up that East Coast right there. So far, until we know what's going to happen past this trough, for the next 7 days, you can see the rainfall amounts. So you have the Bahamas with a couple inches. You got Central America getting some also, but you can see how it starts building up from Jamaica towards the Cayman Islands. With the Cayman Islands getting the heaviest amount, this is only the next 7 days. This would be more past this, but this is going to change. I'm trying to keep it as short as possible with as much accuracy as possible. National Hurricane Center still don't have anything out about this. Still has a disturbance in the Atlantic, which is going to be Gordon trying to come back again, but it ain't going nowhere. Still going to be in the Atlantic, but still nothing about this. And it really needs to be updated because people need to be alerted to potentially preparing for impacts and getting materials. Now, we still got severe weather for today, even a slight risk with an enhanced feature. This is not for tornadoes. Your tornadoes is a 2% showing Glendive and Sydney. Your threat is going to be mainly for winds, and even showing that hurricane forcing that hatched area of black right there and very high winds and at 30%. I'm showing that is also stretching a little bit further to the north. So far, here's your cities and states at risk for the chance for the damaging winds for today. And this is bringing really strong winds. You have 40 in the green. The orange is the 50 miles per hour wind gust. You're starting to get into the 60s in the red, the 70s in the brown, and the 80s and above in that white. Now, as you go through Wednesday, you got another marginal as you get those storms. This is not going to be for tornadoes. This is going to be a chance for slight winds with those. But so far, here's your cities and states at risk for some severe weather for tomorrow, for Wednesday. And you can see as you go for tomorrow, you do have those storms, but you can see how it brews right back up as we're going overnight into Thursday, bringing more storms ahead of that. So for Thursday, so far, here's your severe weather. You do have a 5% and a 15%. And here's your cities and states at risk for Thursday. And that has been a quick update for this afternoon. That way you know what the changes are, what we got to look for and what will change this system. So there's a few things that we need to check on. I will keep you updated on everything I spoke on here. Be aware of the severe weather that is kicking in for today. Also for tomorrow, it will be around all the way till Thursday. Thank you for your time, everybody. Hope you have a very great evening this afternoon. Now, before you go this afternoon, Jeremiah 29, 8 through 15. For thus saith the Lord of hosts, the God of Israel, let not your prophets and your diviners that be in the midst of you deceive you, neither hearken to your dreams which ye cause to be dreamed. For they prophesy falsely unto you in my name. I have not sent them, saith the Lord. For thus saith the Lord, that after 70 years be accomplished at Babylon, I will visit you and perform my good word toward you, and causing you to return to this place. For I know the thoughts that I think toward you, saith the Lord, thoughts of peace and not of evil, to give you an expected end. Then shall ye call upon me, and ye shall go and pray unto me, and I will hearken unto you. And ye shall seek me and find me, when ye shall search for me with all your heart. And I will be found of you, saith the Lord, and I will turn away your captivity, and I will gather you from all the nations, and from all the places whither I have driven you, saith the Lord, and I will bring you again into the place whence I caused you to be carried away captive, because ye have said, the Lord has raised us up prophets in Babylon. Amen. Have a great afternoon, everybody. I will keep you updated on what's going on with this weather pattern and this storm system. I'm showing it's going to be a very strong moment, not just in the Caribbean, also for the lower 48 for the U.S. So I will keep you updated on what is around the corner. I appreciate every single one of y'all. And remember, above all things, all glory goes to God, our Father in heaven, Yahweh. And I always hope he keeps you safe every single day of your life and everyone that is around you and forever. Amen. Hallelujah. Amen. Have a great night. Everyone, don't worry about this. Let me worry about this for you. It still needs to pass this trough in 6 to 7 days away.